Steph, you're in the bottom two.
Being in the sing-off again, it was just like the worst possible turnout. I didn't think Stephanie was gonna go. I thought it'd be me.
Really, all things considered, I have to say Steph.
Yeah! When Andrew said my name, it was just complete shock.
I can't believe it.
I've been in the bottom two twice, so I'm gonna have to really, really fight for my place here.
That performance was fearless.
I'm Dorothy.
Dorothy has to be resilient and she has to have courage, and I think just from my experiences on the show and my bumpy ride that, you know, I have got courage.
It was quite a different performance. I saw a different side to you.
I'm also extremely short.
Steph, you are a diminutive diva.
She is 12 in the film and I am the height of like a 12-year-old. This whole experience has been so intense, but I think it's made me such a stronger person, and you know, it's given me the resilience I need to fulfill this role.
They're all desperate for that role. Saved by the Lord twice and praying for a musical miracle, it's Steph! Our London Lovely is performing somewhere and is hoping to go from West Side Story to West End Glory.
Tonight is really tough. It's a double elimination. Two of you will be going home. You've known about it all week. What's the atmosphere been like back at the house?
It's actually been all right, I think. Like, no, you've got no one trying to poison each other yet. but basically, I think everyone's just trying to enjoy it as much as we can, because obviously two are leaving and don't know what's going to happen. So.
Exactly. It's just anybody's game. And I think it just proves it, you know, with the people who have left, like Stephanie going last week, you just could not be more shocked. And as Steph says, you've just got to hold on to it while it lasts, and because you're never going to get another opportunity like this.
All right, let's check in with the panel. Sheila, two very emotional songs. How did they do?
I thought, Steph, that was absolutely wonderful. I mean, I'm so glad that you're back and you're still with us. There was a moment in the middle of it, it was pure magic, where we saw a moment of doubt that everything was going to be all right, and you recovered and went on. Not doubt of you, but doubt of the character. Beautiful. Jenny, that's a difficult song. It's usually sung by an older actor, but it's about somebody who's had an affair, turned the person away and then gone back to them. And it's ironic. It should be much more humorous. It's a beautiful lyric. And you opted for sad and went sad all the way through. It needed more colour, but it was a good attempt.
John,
Jenny, when you perform an up-tempo number, I love it. When you sing a song like this that has emotional content, I just feel that the acting becomes a bit half-baked. I just want to pop you back in the oven for another 20 minutes, and I know you'd come out beautifully. Did it move me? Did it touch me? If I'm honest, no. Well, you'll get your chance in a minute.
All right.
Steph, here's a place for you, and it is back here on this stage next week in the semi-final. You are proving to be one of our most versatile performers. You can take a Bjork contemporary pop song with choreography and dancers and then come here and sing a song like that tonight with such truth and such beauty. I just hope that people pick up the phone and vote for you tonight.
Charlotte, briefly, what did you think of the girls?
I completely disagree with Jenny. I think there was just moments of real magic in that. I thought it was just kind of simple and it was lovely and your voice sounded really quite classic. And I really enjoyed it, and Steph, that was just special. For a song that's usually sung by a soprano, I thought it was quite big and it was quite brash, but I love that about it. And you've got quite a lot of vibrato, but I just think you're superb.
All right, mixed comments from the panel. Andrew.
Oh, dear, right. You know there are sometimes songs when somebody said something to you and you almost can't take them seriously again? I remember years ago, Steph, that old comedian called Jimmy Edwards, and we went to a fish and chip shop, and he said, "There's a place for us." And ever since that time, I always think of it. But you did really, really well tonight, and you got the words, and you got the meaning of the words. And here, Jenny, I thought you did rather better than I thought you might with that, because of course it's about an older woman. Stephen Sondheim, who wrote that song, said he nearly called it "Sending the Fools" because it's about an older woman making almost a fool of herself because she's fallen in love. A really tough song for a girl as young as you to do. Both of you did very well. Thank you.